This is my Sanwa analog multitester AP33. The box contains the instrument itself, the user's manual, and calibration assurance certificate. The display of this instrument is quite simple, and I like the fact that the range numbers there are spaced apart, so there is less chance of making a wrong selection. The selector switch also makes an assured precise movement. The test leads are quite thin. These are 24 AWG, and I have already measured this beforehand. The length of these test leads is 600 millimeter. The test pins are nice. They have Sanwa branding on them. And I like the fact that even though these are small test pins, they are provided with covers which are removable, and the tips of the test pins themselves are gold plated. Let's test now some of the functions of the AP33. First, the AC voltage measurement. I'm going to measure the outlet here. The instrument does not have a hold function, unfortunately, but it is quite clear enough to read that the voltage being registered by the instrument is a little above 235 volts AC, between 235 and 240 volts. And I'm looking at my digital meter here, and it's actually reading 237 volts. Let me show you. These are some of the rechargeable lithium-ion batteries that I use for my flashlights. They are fully charged, so they should be reading about 4 volts DC. An interesting feature of this AP33 is the inclusion of this 9-volt and 1.5-volt battery tester. Not a lot of analog multimeters have this kind of feature, so let's find out what it's all about. I'm going to use my old 9-volt battery here. That's 9 volts DC, and apparently using the DC 10 volt range there, this battery is still in good health. Now let's switch to the 9 volt battery tester and see the difference. That's a reading of around 8.2 volts DC, still in good health, but there is already a difference of 0.8 volts. Now, according to the user's manual, the AC and DC voltage measurements all across the range, they are using, the instrument is using a 2 kilo ohm per volt input impedance. That's quite high compared to the input impedance of the battery tester, which is 420 ohms for the 9 volt and 14 ohms for the 1.5 volts. This means that using the battery tester, the instrument is actually consuming power, because the 420 ohms there acts as a load, and the 14 ohms input impedance also acts as a load. Since the battery tester here actually presents a load to the battery being tested, This battery tester here actually is a better judge of the true state of the battery in conjunction with the battery health indicators than just the output of the 10 volt DC range there. Let me show you how to properly return the test leads and the test pins in their proper places. The first thing we need to do is just to wind the two wires together at the same time, parallel to each other, without the pulling or applying any kind of tension on them. And on the last corner, there is sufficient slack on the black test pin, and it must be the black test pin first to be inserted in the groove. Its finger guard will easily slide into the groove there. Next, it would be the red test pin with its finger guard also sliding easily into the groove. Now we have the two test leads back to their original places, neat and compact. I think the Sanwa Multitester AP33 represents a good value, at least for me. This is lightweight, neat and compact, and it contains the most basic measurement functions, including a useful battery tester. It has an uncluttered interface, which is easy to use, and built-in test leads and test pins, making this easy to carry around, and it fits in my shirt pocket. If you like this video, please share and subscribe to my channel. I'd appreciate it a lot. Let me know what you think of the Sanwa Multitester AP33 in the comments below. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.